Hello students, how are you? I hope all of you are fine. So student, in the previous part of the video, we have discussed the sum of first n terms of an AP. And based on that formula, we have solved one example also, okay? So today, we will solve some more examples on the sum of first n terms of an AP, okay? This is the last part, student, and I will tell you around 7 to 8 questions on this formula so that you will be comfortable to this concept, okay? So, question is that if the sum of first 14 terms of an AP is 1050 and its first term is 10, find the 20th term, okay? I am repeating the question one more time. If the sum of first 14 terms of an AP is 1050 and its first term is 10, find the 20th term, okay? So, before solving this question, whatever information are given in the question, we will write it, okay? So, in this question, the first term is given, okay? So, first term is represented by small a. So, small a is equal to 10, okay? The value of first term is 10, which is represented by small a. And student, the sum of first 14 terms of an AP is 1050, okay? So we know that sum of first n terms of an AP, which is equal to Sn is equal to sum of first n terms of an AP, which is equal to n by 2 in bracket 2a plus n minus 1 d bracket closed. So this is the formula of sum of first n terms, okay? But in the question, it is given that the sum of first 14 terms, it means that student, first 14 now, so in place of n, what is given? 14. So n equal to 14. So when we will put n equal to 14 in this formula, what will become? S14 is equal to 14 by 2 in bracket the first 2 into first term is a, that is 10. 10 plus n minus 1, that is 14 minus 1, and d we don't know, okay? And this S14 is given, student. Sum of first 14 term is given. How much? 1050. It means that here we can write it. S14 is given equal to 1050. Sum of first 14 terms, which value is equal to 1050. And when we have applied the formula, we have got this much statement. Okay. So in place of S14, we can put 1050. Now you can solve it. So, 14 divided by 2, that is 7, in bracket, 20 plus 14 minus 1, 13, and 13 into d, 13d, okay? Now, either you will multiply this 7 in the bracket, or you will divide this 7 to this side. So, I am dividing this, so 1050 upon 7 equal to 20 plus 13d. It is clear, student? Now, when 1050 is divided by 7, it will come 150. Okay, because 15, 7 is 105, and because 0 is there, so that's why 50. Okay, is equal to 20 plus 13d. Now, when this 20 will come this side, 150 minus 20 equal to 13d. Now, 130 is equal to 13d. So d will be equal to 130 upon 13. What is 10? So it means that what is d, student? D is known as the common difference of an AP. So by solving this all statements, by putting all the values in the sum formula, we have got the value of common difference, and which value is equal to 10. So we have to find 20th term, na? We have to find, student, 20th term. So after that, I am writing here. So So 20th term of an AP, and 20th term is written by T20, and when we have to got a particular term, so what we do, we add 1 less than D, means it is 20th term na? So how many D we will add? We will add 19 D in what? In the first term. It means T20 can be written as A plus 19 D. If you don't know how to write this, so you can apply the formula of Tn also. Tn is equal to what is student? A plus n minus 1 D na? Tn is equal to A plus n minus 1 D, where Tn is known as the Lth term. So when you will put n equal to 20 here, so same statement you will get. Okay? So now, you know the value of A, you know the value of D. So T20 will be equal to, the value of A is 10 and the value of D is also 10. Okay? So 10 plus 190, which is equal to 200. So it means that our 20th term come equal to 200. Okay? So that is the answer. I hope you have understood this question. This is the very important question and used to come in the board examination of 3 marks. Okay, so note down it. Now student, next example is that, I hope you have understood the first example, means first question, whatever I told you today. Now it is the second question. Now see the question, how many terms of the AP, AP is 24, 21, 18 and so on, must be taken so that their sum is 78, okay? I am going to repeat the question one more time. How many terms of the AP, and the AP is 24, 21, 18 and so on, must be taken so that their sum is 78? If you don't understand this question, I can tell you. How many terms of an AP can be added so that their sum will be equal to 78? Okay, it means you have to find the number of terms, and number of terms is denoted by small n. It means that we have to find the value of n. Okay, so first, whatever information is given, we will write it. So AP is what, student? AP is 24, 21, 18... Okay? So, from seeing this AP, we can see its first term is 24. So, it means A equal to 24, because A is, first term is denoted by small a. Now, common difference, that is D, and D can be calculated by difference of two consecutive terms. Suppose I am taking these two, so their difference can be calculated as 21 minus 24. So it means common difference come minus 3. How many terms? It means we have to find the number of terms. So number of terms we have to calculate, means how many terms we will add so that their sum is equal to 78. So I have assumed there are n terms. I have assumed that there are n terms whose sum are equal to 78. So the value of n we have to calculate, and the value of Sn, because their sum is given, means sum of n terms is given. So that is equal to 78. So that much information is given. First term is 24, common difference is minus 3, number of terms we have to calculate, and the number of sum of the number of terms is 78. So we can apply the formula. So sum of first n terms is equal to Sn equal to n by 2 in bracket 2a plus n minus 1 d. Okay, now Sn value is given, how much? 78, means sum value is given. Okay, and we don't know, so it is written like that only, n by 2. A is equal to 24, n is don't know, and D is equal to minus 3. That much value we have put in the equation. Now it is 78 is equal to n by 2. Now 2 into 24 will be 48. And now see student, minus 3 into n, minus 3n, and because plus sign is there, so minus will be there. So it will be minus 3n, and minus 1 into minus 3 will become plus 3. Okay? I hope it is clear to you. Now what you do, you transfer these two to that side. Means you cross multiply these two to that side. So it will be 78 into 2 is equal to n. And see, 48 plus 3 will be 51 minus 3n. Okay? Now multiply it. So 78 into 2 will be 156. It will be 51n. And it will be minus 3n square. Okay? Now what you do, student? You transfer all these terms to left hand side and make it right hand side 0. Okay? So I can write, by transferring all terms to the left side, 3n square minus 51n plus 156 equal to 0. Now see, here we formed a quadratic equation. Quadratic equation in variable what? In variable n. So we have to solve for n. So it means we have to solve the equation. So you know, you have understood the concept of quadratic equation, how to find the roots. So by that method only you can find out, either by factorization method or by quadratic formula or by completing the square. So let us see which example, which method I am going to use. First, I will see there is anything common between the terms or not. So by seeing that, I can say 3 is a common. Okay. So when I will take 3 as a common, in bracket what will left? N square minus 17n plus 52 equal to 0. Now when 3 will divide it to that side, it will become 0. So what will left? Left will be n square minus 17n plus 52 equal to 0. Because when 3 will divide to this side, 0 by any number is equal to 0 only. Okay? Unless this number is 0. Okay? So here is 3. 0 divided by 3 is what? 0 divided by 3 is equal to 0 only. So see, we have framed a quadratic equation. Now you can use any method to solve it. So I'm using factorization method. So see, 1 into 52, 52. So I have to take 2 factor of 52 so that when I will add them, it will be 17. Because plus sign is here, that's why I'm adding. So I think 13 and 4. So this can be written as n square minus 13n plus 4n plus 52 equal to 0. Now open the bracket. So when you will open the bracket, it will come n square minus 13n minus 4n plus 52 equal to 0. Okay? Now students, see, I am solving here. So when you will factorize it, between these two, what will common? N will common, so it will be n minus 13, and between these two, minus 4 will come common. So minus 4 is n in bracket, n minus 13 will common. Now, it will be n minus 13 and n minus 4 equal to 0. Now you got two factors now. One is n minus 13 and the second one is n minus 4. So one by one, separately, we will equate these two factors equal to 0. So when n minus 13 equal to 0, n will be 13 only. And when n minus 4 equal to 0, n equal to 4. So it means that we got first 13 terms and then 4 terms. So both will be the answer. Both will be the answer. Now why both will be the answer? Now see student, answer will be that there are 13 terms whose sum are 78 and there are also 4 terms whose sum are 78. Why we got two answers? Can you tell the reason why we have got two answers? The answer is that because by seeing this AP, you can say it is a decreasing AP. Okay? So see, 24, 21, 18, then what will come? 15, then 12, means it is decreasing. So when we have seen this AP, we can say that there are some positive terms in the AP and there are some negative terms in the AP. Okay, so it means that there can be two values of n. Okay, if the common difference is positive, then suppose when we have calculated the common difference and common difference comes positive, so it in that case there can be only one values. Okay, because all number will increase. But here the common difference was negative, so it shows that according to this AP there will be some positive terms like 24, 21, 18, and there will be some negative terms also. Okay, so when the common difference is negative of any AP, so there can be possibility that there can be two values of n whose sum are equal to 78. So answer will be n equal to 13 and n equal to 4. Both answer is correct. It is possible only when the common difference is negative. Okay, so I hope you have understood. So please note down it. Now student, another different example of this part is that it is very important question, student, and it usually come in the board examination. So question is that find the sum of first 24 terms of the list of the numbers whose nth term is given by an equal to 3 plus 2n. Means the nth term of an AP is given in the question, that is an equal to 3 plus 2n. This is the nth term, and with the help of this you have to find the sum of first 24 terms of the AP. So what is the meaning of nth term? Nth term means when we will put the value of n, we will get that term. Means suppose n equal to 1, so which term it will be? First term. Okay, suppose n equal to 2, so whatever value we will get by putting the value of n equal to 2, that will be the second term. When I will put n equal to 3, so that will our third term. Means in nth term, when we will put the value of n like 1, 2, 3, 4, so that much term we can calculate. Means when n equal to 1, that will be known as first term. When n equal to 2, that will be our second term. When n equal to 3, that will be our third term, and so on. So it is possible only when the nth term is given. So nth term is given. So what I will do, nth term is an equal to 3 plus 2n. Okay, so if n equal to 1, so it means it is a1, that is 3 plus 2 into 1. So how much it will come? 3 plus 2, it means a1 equal to 5. So a1 is what? First term. It is nth term. So n, when n equal to 1, so we will get first term. Similarly, when n equal to 2, because in the question AP is not given, only nth term is given, so our first priority is that we will know the first, second, third terms of the AP, and from that we can get our first term, common difference, and with the help of that we can calculate the sum of first 24 terms. So when n equal to 2, so we will get a2, and a2 is our second term, so it will be 3 plus 2 into 2. So a2 equal to 3 plus 4, so a2 equal to how much? 7. So it means second term is 7. Similarly, I usually write t2, t1, but in the question in terms of this is given, so that is also okay. First term is a1, second term is a2. Similarly, when n equal to 3, we can get a3, and a3 is equal to 3 plus 2 into 3. So a3 is equal to 3 plus 6, which is equal to 9. Okay? first term is 5, second term is 7, third term is 9. Similarly, one more we can calculate. When n is equal to 4, so a4 will be equal to 3 plus 2 into 4. So a4 equal to 3 plus 8. So a4 equal to 11. Similarly, we can find number of terms, okay? So first 4 terms we have calculated, okay? So the AP will be what? So the AP will be a1, a2, a3, a4, ... and so on. So a1 is what? A1 is 5, a2 is 7, a3 is 9, a4 is 11, and so on. So we have made the AP. We have formed one AP whose terms are 5, 7, 9, and 11. So from there we can say na, our first term is what? So first term that is denoted by A, which is equal to 5, common difference that is denoted by small d, and a common difference is what? 7 minus 5, which is equal to 2. I told you how to calculate common difference. So first term is 5, common difference d is equal to 2. So what we have to do, student? We have to find the sum of first 24 terms now. So first 24 terms, it means n equal to how much? 24. So we know that sum of first n terms is SN, na? And SN equal to n by 2 in bracket 2a plus n minus 1 d, bracket close. And we have to find the sum of first 24 terms. So in place of n, how much we will put? We will put 24, because we have to find up to 24 term only. So I can put n equal to 24 here. So 24 by 2 in bracket 2 into, first term was what? First term was 5, so 2 into 5 plus the value of n is 24 minus 1, and the value of d is 2. Now it will be cancelled, student, no? So it will be 12 only. Now 2 into 5, that is 10, plus 24 minus 1, that is 23 into 2. Now 12 in bracket 10 plus 23 2s are 46. So what we can get here will be 12, and it is 10 plus 46 is equal to 56. Okay, so when you will multiply 12 into 56, what you will get, student? You will get 672. Okay, you will get 672. So it means that the sum of first 24 terms is 672. So when this type of question comes, means an is given, ap is not given, the nth term is given. So first you will form an ap, and how will you form an ap? By putting the value of n equal to 1, 2, 3, and so on. When you will put in the nth term, by putting n equal to 1, you can get the first term. By putting n equal to 2, you can get the second term. Similarly, n equal to 3, you can get the third term, and so on. So you will form an AP. By seeing that AP, you can say the first term, you can say the common difference. So whatever the sum you have to calculate, means what up to what terms you have to calculate the sum, you can calculate with the help of this formula. Okay? So I hope you have understood all three questions, whatever I have discussed today. Some more questions are left, which we will discuss in the next part, so that this chapter will be over. And the exercise you have to do by yourself. Okay? So I hope you have liked the video. So practice all the questions, and whatever questions are remaining, that we will discuss in the next part of the video. So till then, have a nice day, children. Thank you.